Are these people died. Behind the bar?
No, okay.
It's Chesty St. Square.
And?
QB
Gooding Jr. What I love the most about this setting here
is... It's the Buster Call.
But look at this right here, right? Like, so on one table to your right, there's just lobster, one of the most expensive foods. And then to the right of that is wine.
Two bottles of wine.
Why?
One party.
Why are pirates so...
Oh, look at that rice.
Oh, there you got some rice. Here over here you got some beer and some big steaks. More rice.
I want a small barrel of ale.
Yeah, I know, eh?
Yeah, where's my small barrel of ale?
We're going to do this, this time we're going to do episode Whitebeard from the Paramount War.
Episode Whitebeard. Quest for Whitebeard's Whitebeard. He lost it once in a fight. All he has now is his impossible mustache.
Was it ever brought up that Whitebeard does not have a beard?
I don't know. I don't know if they ever brought that up. Does Blackbeard not have a mustache?
Blackbeard has a small neck beard.
He has a bit of a beard.
He has a bit of a bristle mustache.
I don't really know his face off by heart.
No, he doesn't have a mustache, but he has like little bristly bits of facial hair over his lip.
Look at that winning smile.
I mean, Hulk Hogan's winning smile.
Yeah, look, it's Hulk Hogan.
What you gonna do when the Whitebeard comes? Whatever, that's more of a... It's just funny, like, Luke knows about One Piece and wrestling.
Yeah, and we keep referencing both of them. Or keep... There he broke the game.
Oh, right. Oh, we didn't know he could do that for some reason.
What the... That doesn't seem physically possible.
Oh, here we are. What happened now?
An explosion? Desu?
Oh, Jesus.
So he can just crack anything.
A sea quake! Oh, man. Look at that smile! He almost looked surprised he could do it.
Dumb face. With his dumb bird, and his dumb hat, and his dumb beard, and dumb hair.
His dumb anal beads beard.
And dumb mustache that frames his lips entirely. He has the power to destroy the world, Good for him, though.
Good for him!
Except for the fact that he's going to get washed away by the ocean that he made to.
Nah, it's alright because,
Ace is here.
Steve Aoki or whatever's gonna freeze it. What's his name? There he is. Aokiji?
Man, look at that. It's X-Men.
There you go. It's a tsunami from two different sides.
That doesn't seem physically what's he doing here?
He was there. This was the first time I think he appeared, like, in full.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure in the anime and manga, Crocodile fought him. There you go. See, Steve Aoki's gonna fix it.
So...
Legendary, DJ.
Why did he do that?
To just kill everything?
Yeah, but he was in the middle of it.
Yeah, but he's...
You son of a gun!
You son of a gun!
He doesn't have a beard.
Who?
Or a beard or whatever. White mustache.
Yeah, White don't call him White Beard.
White Starch, that's his name now. His name is White Starch.
You broke my... Whatever.
Battleship.
You sunk my battleship. What is this all about?
All this time, when you get to the end of One Piece, you find out that it was just a game of Battleship.
The Battleship. Hasbro's Battleship.
Played by Shikamaru and...
Oh, hold on a second.
Neji.
Why would they be playing Battleship?
It was a long con. It was actually a promotion for a game inside of Naruto.
It's a Naruto the whole time.
The whole time. If you can believe it. Wow. Wow, that...
It's like how Toriko needed to ride the coattails of One Piece to success.
Oh, yeah?
Did you know that the first episode of Toriko, the anime, was a... crossover between it and
that's
One Piece.
That's right, it was.
Just in case you didn't have enough confidence in it. Oh, I totally nailed
it. So calm.
Why is everyone so, like, chilled out? It's like, yeah, I just caught this. It's all good.
I also love the description. It's like, not to be outdone, he stabbed a piece of magma and put it out. Yeah, that's the kind of guy he is.
That was the only reason he did that, not to suspend death.
So what kind of fighting is One Beard doing that he only gets scars on his chest?
One Beard.
That he has like three or four scars on his chest.
Remember his best mate stabbed him in the chest or whatever that was?
Yeah, but the ones that are already scars, like, does he just run into battle pecs first?
I would imagine that's exactly what he does. He's
like, come at me, demons.
Demons?
Yeah, of the ocean.
Because you know he's, yeah, that's what he calls like whales
or
dolphins.
Chest thrust.
There is no escape from, I don't know, I can crack reality, I think.
Yeah, remember when I can crack the air? That was cool.
Yeah, I can make a earthquake, airquake, skyquake, and seaquake. Think of one other thing that has not already been quaked, I can quake it. You know the game Quake?
Oh yeah.
I can't quake that.
It's already been quaked.
It's already been quaked.
It's been pre-quaked.
Yeah, it's been pre-quaked.
Here I come.
Unreal Tournament though, I can quake that.
You can quake the shit out of that. So what's his ultimate?
Yeah, what was the question?
I don't know what was his ultimate, but he K-crossed him before I could get it.
Yeah, I K-crossed him.
My favorite thing about fighting games like this is where they make you win and then it doesn't matter in the next cutscene.
Yeah, that was the thing with Ace. It was like you had to fight as Ace and then Ace dies, so.
Yeah. It might have, I can't even remember, it might have even just been like to survive the match, which is even more dickish because he doesn't survive.
No, he doesn't survive.
But it's like, you have to survive. Oh look, it's Big Head Ivankov.
Does Ivankov just continue to change size?
There's Crocodilicus. Turn to a woman.
A little bit of Crocodilicus is cool. Here we are. A critical battlefield.
This seems to have less cutscenes than the Luffy chapter. This was in the Luffy chapter.
Yeah.
But we didn't actually do this fight. Crocodile turned up and we said, man.
Not today.
Remember when this happened? And it was like, no. Actually, we did do this fight. What was it? We did.
Well, Whitebeard was in this fight.
Was he?
Yeah. Look, he's our support. He's our support.
We have to do this fight. It's only two episodes in and we got to do the same fight.
Yeah, but I'll finish this off quicker than before.
Is this game just the war?
It shouldn't be.
Because I noticed that Luffy is called Luffy 2 years ago.
Yeah, if you play like free play mode, there is Luffy. He's just called Luffy, and it's
as for story mode, like chapters.
I'm not sure. Maybe it's Luffy, just the war.
It's Luffy chapter, and then Whitebeard chapter. I don't know if we do Ace chapter, where we just kind of chained to the ground for a while.
You get the shit kicked out of us for a while.
Crocodile chapter, where we do one fight and get beaten up by Luffy. We could do Marine chapter, where we're that guy in the back on the
who's
far
just like,
left,
yeah.
Who's doing the
gotcha,
war reenactment.
I gotcha. Fuck, you're big.
Did you come to save your brother, Desu?
I love his side abs.
He works out. They're crazy. Like, you look at him, his forehead is jacked.
Yeah, forehead abs. A lot of people from One Piece just do not have eyebrows.
Yeah, because why bother?
They have eye...
Yeah, you shave your eyebrows, it helps prevent scurvy.
Really?
Probably not, but I'm sure that someone got told that. And they all
I heard lime helps that.
They don't have lime, they just eat meat on a stick.
Yeah, that's why they need to have
and
some
and the stick
lime
is a bone. Because if you watch anime, that's how meat works, but that's not how meat works. Which is just a single comical bone and a complete cylinder of meat surrounding
said bone.
Yeah,
what cut of the animal is that?
I don't know, it's some kind of thigh.
I mean, like, so Dragon Ball Z kind of started that shit. I mean, I guess they get a pass because I think dinosaurs still existed. Maybe that's what dinosaur meat looks like.
At least in the filler it did. Remember Icarus?
Yes.
He was a thing in the filler.
Does Bulma not get chased by a giant T-Rex early on in the piece?
I think dinosaurs are a thing.
They're definitely a thing.
I'm just trying to remember who else got cut.
Do you know of the Goku figurine? Of the Goku figurine with him riding a small dinosaur? Have you ever seen that?
I have seen that one. That's like casual Goku. Where he's riding got like a jacket and goggles on.
Yeah, so casual, he's tamed and he's now riding a
dinosaur. It's like the stuff he wears when he's not fighting and he has like a weird anime fashion sense. Oh, he's sad. That the only time he ever wears that is like that episode where he was going to drive a car.
That was really dumb.
Or in that brief period before the androids fought and him and Gohan were Super Saiyan all the time. He had like He had like that
weird
like,
scarf?
No, he had like that weird like orange jacket, like that puffy... like Marty McFly looking jacket.
What am I thinking of? He was wearing Namekian clothing. When were they
was
wearing
that?
Was
that when he had the really big neck thing?
Yes, that big scarf.
That was when he came back after the Frieza thing. They thought he died. Remember we went to that alien planet and they taught him instant transmission? And he came back wearing their like native garb.
That's right.
And he was like, I could have zapped back any time, but Trunks looked like he had it handled. I met some dudes. They were all aliens. They all wore the same thing and looked the same. They taught me how to zap around the place. It was pretty cool.
It was pretty cool.
It sure is a useful ability that I'm never going to zap any of you back to ever learn.
No.
Well, maybe he left that planet on bad terms. Although if they gave him clothes and a ship, I wouldn't think...
Yeah, I can't imagine he left on bad terms. Maybe there could have been better terms?
Maybe. Or even then, he could have taught someone else the attack. Or not attack, but like a method of attack. It's part of one of the coolest attacks in Dragon Ball Z.
Which one are you referring to?
The instant Kamehameha.
I was going to say instant transmission Kamehameha.
That's the coolest attack because it's like the middle finger of energy blasts. He's like up in the sky and he's charging. They're like, what's he going to do? He's going to dodge it up. He's actually under you now and then he just destroys you.
Yeah, good night.
Take that, Cell. You dick. Cell's a dick.
No, he's alright.
He's a dick. He made a game show so that he could show the world dying. And then go kill the world.
Yeah? What's your point?
He's a dick.
Not a fan?
No. Although I'm surprised the future was still in such... I mean, the future was in terrible shape, but I'm surprised anyone was left alive in the future with the androids going around zapping stuff willy-nilly. They're like, pew-pow, pew!
Sorry, I'm very focused on actually playing the game. Pretty sure
in the future, Android 18 wanted to kill some guys just because she lost a video game. So video games were still a thing in the future.
Well, I imagine as much.
Or maybe an arcade machine. She's probably talking about an arcade machine.
Which existed back in the 90s when this series was
on. When Dragon Ball Z was on.
I'm fairly certain. I mean, they still exist now, but not to the same capacity. No way.
That was the dark future that wasn't averted because she didn't meet Krillin back in the past and hook up. And have a kid named after his ex-girlfriend.
Oh, that's weird. Is that not weird?
It's weird, but the ex-girlfriend was only in the filler, so Toriyama didn't come up with that.
Oh, okay.
So it's not named after her, they just have the same name.
What do you mean filler? What are you referring to, one of the movies?
Or in the anime, like some episodes that weren't in the manga. Like, just some filler that happened. Like,
I didn't realize there was.
Goku learns to drive, or I don't know. Bunch of the Icarus stuff or something. Or like, I think Dragon Ball may have put a few episodes here and there, and maybe not necessarily done entire arcs of filler.
Yeah.
That's why they have their iconic, 30-something episode battles. Because they were stretching it out.
That's right, yeah.
So a lot of attacks launched that, you know, never were used or anything like that.
It's funny, like, reading through the manga, you realize how... It wasn't that played out. Like the Raditz saga.
Yeah, that was...
Raditz coming to Earth and like being defeated was like 3 volumes.
The only thing Raditz was worth doing is telling Goku that he was an alien and he died.
He died.
I think Goku died. Piccolo killed him and raised Gohan. It's a weird dynamic.
Actually, no, it wasn't just that. It was the Saiyan saga, which means like it was like Raditz, Nappa, and Vegeta. That whole arc was done in 3 volumes of the manga. And it took like 50 episodes.
I guess, but Raditz also feels like the preamble to the Saiyan saga. Like every major arc in Dragon Ball has the early arc. You've got Cell, but before that you had the androids, which are technically their own saga, but it was the precursor to Cell.
What was the precursor to?
Probably the World Tournament arc with Popovich and Babidi and Deborah and all that.
I liked Deborah.
Before Boo turned up.
Good night, guys.
And turned him into chocolate.
Good night, the Moby Dick.
Oh.
We hardly knew ye.
Rest well. Rest well and sleep. By my impossible chin and neck, I will avenge you, Boat. You will be avenged, Boat.
Thank you, Boat. Oh, it's really good that everyone can do like triple damage to me.
Yeah.
Like, and I have to also fight 3 of them. I think that's really fair.
Yeah, that's the best part.
So I just kind of have to button mash?
What's sarcasm?
Oh, buddy.
I'm just kidding. I get sarcasm.
So this game is really good for dodging if you have a small character that can actually dodge. With Whitebeard, his model is so big, there's literally no point actually dodging because they'll just get you anyway.
Just hit them really hard with your stick.
With my stick?
Yeah.
With my knife stick.
Shatter him.
Good night, and I'll send you into the distance. That is where you belong. Kizaru, you stupid monkey prick.
What if you use your ultimate Whitebeard attack on him?
I'm definitely going to try. Use your ultimate Whitebeard attack on him.
Half your mustache is gone. Use your ultimate Whitebeard attack.
Oh, I did actually try to use my ultimate Whitebeard, but he kills me instantaneously.
Sorry.
And that was very startling. Okay, you had to.
Half your mustache was gone.
Yeah, it's because I was damaged.
Damaged.
Here you go. Don't know why they make this game as hard as it is.
Because screw you, that's why.
Very good. I feel like I should be doing a lot more damage than I am, considering I have to fight three of these idiots.
This is because you...
Oh, and I love how you can be interrupted mid-special attack. That's the best part about this game. Oh, and I've died.
I love that that's your favorite part.
Yeah, it is my favorite part.
That was said a lot in the first episode.
Yeah, I love that.
Not all of them made the cut, but it was said a lot.
I imagine, yeah, it was said many times.
You know my favorite part about this game is the fact you be interrupted when you attack. You know what my favorite part about this game is? The fact that their gauge fills up faster than mine. My favorite part of this game is...
I hope all those make it in. Oh, sorry, excuse me. I cannot do my special attack because... This is another thing that I absolutely fucking love, is that I can just be instantly killed by a character.
Use your special attack on the second guy, so that when you get to the third guy, you have more health.
Now, Kane, why would you say something stupid like that?
Because punch this guy in the dick.
But I'm using a giant stick.
Stab this guy in the dick.
Oh, and once again, tried to dodge, could not.
Let him cover you in fire, so yeah. That when the guy covers you in ice, it won't work.
I'll be okay.
Because you'll be on fire.
Also, I can't use my special move on the middle guy, because I need to use him to save up my gauge to do the special move.
Yeah, it's a likely gauge-based story there.
It is quite likely.
Oh, so you blew up behind him.
There you go. Aokiji. Steve Aokiji. Oh!
You were just kind of standing there for a second.
I was guarding. Not that it fucking matters. Please get out of here. Yes, Kizaru, leave. If you're allowed to kill me with pot shots, I'm also allowed to do this.
I will allow this.
Well, you allow...
I will allow this pot shottery.
I'm not gonna let him just live. I'm gonna kill him in quite a spectacular way.
Press that stick.
Dodge this!
Well, don't invite him to try.
And he did dodge
you
this.
You punched him in the dick!
Kane's dying! Loving the dick punch! Right in the dick!
From the side, that was a side dick punch.
That was worth the losing several times.
That was entirely just like, boom!
Dick punch.
Right in there. Right in the side.
Hopefully that was the final battle of this particular arc.
Look at that shark, bro.
Oh, he's not happy.
Oh, shark, bro.
Oh, dude, shark, bro. That guy's a street shark.
Oh, shit.
He's a street shark.
Oh, what a rough and tumble guy that is.
Did you know One Piece was a...
Spin-off of street sharks?
Yeah, street sharks. Ice ball.
I'd always assumed, but I never knew.
Oh, shit. We instantly died.
Oh, cool.
He died as he lived. Smiling.
Oh, dear. It did. Why are they all so calm?
Who killed Blanca?
Vega.
No. Not from Street Fighter.
Captain Vega. Of the... claw pirates.
You just made that up, didn't you?
Maybe, but prove me wrong. One Piece has a cast of 10 trillion. Oh!
It's Diamond Josu! Here he is. Diamond Josu?
What's your power? He looks like a Dr. Seuss character.
Oh my god. How many times that was
real? Was that just real fire?
That was just real fire!
I love it when they do that.
Goo-ra-ra-ra-ra. Then you'd better defend it.
I love Goo-ra-ra-ra.
It's my favorite
show. My favorite show. Where's Celty? Celty.
Celty, help.
Where's your horse bike? Come help us out.
Am I supposed to just survive? I'm not doing any damage to... Like, I'm doing barely any damage to him.
Watashi want to survive this.
Watashi want to survive. Watashi, can you survive this?
Can you?
I actually can.
See? Whitebeard survived the double lava punch. Ace gets lava punch once, and he dies. What the hell, man? You're made of fire, too.
Yeah, but you wanted to save Luffy.
Yeah, I know.
You sounds like you're giving me shit for it.
Why you push Luffy out of the way? What are you doing?
He didn't have time.
Throw an Enkei in there. And then solve everyone's problems.
I died.
Really? I didn't know. Really?
Alright, man.
Your lord's halfway across the world.
Alright, dude.
Face first into a rock.
Okay, why not let you be so salty?
Got, also probably got cut a little bit by all of the pirates in the background who aren't actually killing each other.
They're only pretending.
Someone die!
Come on, man.
Someone in the background die.
Are you dying?
Yes. I am.
Well, alright then.
Can you not hear it in my voice?
I actually can hear it in your voice. It's quite startling. I've never seen you sick before, so... Not ever want to do something when you are sick, at least.
I'll just cough all over you. And then
I've already been sick. I don't need to be sick again.
Just once.
I was sick
once. I've already been sick. I was 7. Thank you very much.
Guy keeps guarding. Let's do something about
that. I walked
that.
Outside into the rain because I thought it would be fun. And it was. So, I win. Points to me. Kid Frank. Imagine if everyone called themselves, like, as a kid, you had to put kid in front of your name. It's like a reverse Japanese, like, honorific. That you always had to call yourself kid until kid. You were, like, 18.
And also like, speak in third person only.
Well, you know, I don't know, you'd sound like some kind of pirate or cowboy. It's like, here comes Kid Frank.
Kid Frank.
Comes strolling in with your six shooters and your pirate hat, because you're both cowboy and pirate.
And a pirate, yeah.
Oh, come on, Whitebeard. Grow a beard.
He can't. Look how smooth he is.
He's so smooth.
His face, I mean. He's his like, mentality.
That's like a Mr. Potato Head mustache.
It has
like the little clips that go in the nose.
He has a little hole on his upper lip. The rage of what beard?
Rage of what beard?
What beard?
Yeah.
Because he has
that.
No beard.
He's like, and white beard. It's like someone on the ship. More like, what beard?
What? Nothing. What'd you say?
I just got in the background, white beard like pulling at the air.
Ooh, so I should have had my non-beard.
Walk the air, bitch. You don't have the right to ride Moby Dick.
How about you ride my dick, you piece of shit? Oh, here we go. Whitebeard is enraged.
He just punches him in the head. Dies.
He does.
Oh, shit, he did.
I don't know if he dies, though.
Oh, he had a tremor punch. I don't know how that works.
Well, did you see how before he airquaked?
Yeah,
it's not like that.
But it's like, I get fire punch and I get lava punch.
You do, you do get those.
Because that's added.
Yeah.
You like rock because that's some added force behind it.
Sure.
Yo,
what
man.
Is your issue?
He's like, his power is to create that stuff.
Yes.
I don't get the coating his hand in it.
Yes.
I don't fully get it.
Uh-huh.
I don't really understand where the extra force comes from.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Maybe it's an ability of his. I don't know.
Yes.
I haven't really watched all of One Piece.
Oh, and even if you did, it wouldn't make sense.
But
he has the ability to crack the air. How does that, like, help him when he coats his fist in it?
How does he, when he coats his fist in air cracking
energy?
That might be it, actually. I don't even know.
Yeah, that's probably it.
Also, put on a shirt, man.
Who?
Whitebeard.
I have a long jacket that I just drape over my shoulders.
Yeah, but put a shirt on under it, man.
I've been busy.
It'd be funny.
It'd be funny. That's what they say to him. It'd be funny. No, you're right. Yeah, it would be funny.
Because I'm picturing him wearing, like, the first mate pirate shirt, like the striped one.
Yeah.
And that's funny.
Yeah, I bet it would be funny.
Because he's just, like, a super jacked first mate.
Did he have the beard?
Yeah, the smaller one.
Who was his first mate to? Gold Roger?
I don't know.
No, Silver's Rayleigh was first mate to Gold Roger.
Oh, because gold and silver.
You got that? You like that one?
It's naming.
But you think you're funny, Ichiro Oda, don't you? You piece of shit.
It's like the Monkey D family.
Ah, it is like that. Please explain how it's like that.
They're just naming schemes. Or Sanji.
That is funny.
The chef.
Did you know his original name was supposed to be Naruto?
I did hear that, yeah. That's why he's got the swelling.
Who told you?
So the D stands for devil, right?
I don't know. Everyone seems to have this D.
Hey now.
Yeah, they do.
Well, they keep saying that the D is the enemy of God, so I'm going to assume it's devil. And devil fruit and devil. They're probably like the dudes that made the devil fruits or something. Or the original founders of the devil fruit. I don't know.
And he has, like, so little teeth.
Did you win that fight?
Yep.
Yeah, Marshall D. Teeth.
Ah, because he has none.
It's an ironic name. I have lots of guns.
Dude, you're disgusting.
He gets a new gun every time he loses a tooth.
You have so many more guns.
He's probably, like, the most realistic looking pirate in One Piece. Because pirates were out on a boat for 6 months, and they didn't have showers or vitamins.
You mean they all didn't look like Ace?
No, they weren't all shredded 20-somethings with a propensity for cargo shorts and wicked skateboard tricks.
You mean not all pirates knew how to ollie or kickflip?
No, I don't think so.
I don't know if you know much about pirates, man. I think you're incorrect.
All pirates did know how to pop shove it, though.
Oh, they did?
They all knew how to do that.
At least that.
But ollies were beyond most of them. It was surprising.
There was one pirate that could ollie. That was Gold Roger.
It was. Gold Roger. He's the one pirate that could ollie. That's what One Piece is. It's like a...
It's like a special truck.
It's like a pirate.
You can give your board.
It's a pirate scroll that teaches you how to do
pop shove it.
It's a cool deck.
Yeah, it's a World Industries deck from 1996. Like that's it has like Flame Boy on it or something. You're like, dude, this deck is so fucking rare.
Yo.
Here's how the story goes. Oh man.
I'd laugh if that's what it was.
I would laugh. You know what I'd do? I'd ring you and say, I think something's wrong with us because we somehow guessed something so incredibly specific.
I'd find it even funnier if we were only slightly wrong. Like they get there and it's like
someone, it's a wet willy deck instead of like a flame boy one.
It's,
like
it's someone's old lunchbox full of tech decks. It's Gold Rogers from when he was in school.
Yeah, it's not a world. It's like an element deck. Like it's not.
Damn it!
It's not World Industries.
We were so close.
Shit. God damn it. Is this grip tape? Why the fuck? I know oddly a lot about skateboards. I used to be into skate culture when I was younger, but
Gold Roger rode Goofy actually.
Fucking creature style. Yeah, do you know Gold Roger was on the fucking cover of Thrasher magazine 40 times?
You know Gold Roger is actually Tony Hawk? Can you believe that?
Oh my god.
His real name is Tony D. Hawk.
Rob D. Dydrek? That's...
Monkey D. Hawk.
Bam D. Machera.
His actual name is Roronora Majera.
Nora, Nora, Nacho. Oh my god. Oh, I was gonna say, I think I'm doing better.
I don't know any other skaters. I'm not good at skaters.
I'm like Rora Nora Margera.
I don't know any other skaters, I'm not that knowledgeable.
Oh, it's unfortunate you don't know more skaters. Oh, I was so close to beating him too.
I wish I did.
That's the One Piece. Is a really dope ass deck. It's all scratched up and shit because he used to use it heaps. It's not even like a new one. He got it and used it heaps. Oh, what do you want, Blackbeard? Jesus.
Oh, jeez.
Why am I already down so much health? Didn't we just start? How am I so far down? Do skateboarders like rap culture?
Yeah, Sanji's original name was Ben Margera.
I'm pretty sure, yeah. Sanji's original name was Ben Margera, and then changed it to Sanji when Naruto came out.
Oh, I'm dying over here.
You have to excuse Kane's coughing, because it makes things so much funnier.
I bet he wouldn't even know what to do with the One Piece.
Nah, but that's why it comes with the scroll. It teaches you how to punch off it.
He tries the nose grind and then, like, falls over and dies.
Love that he falls over and dies.
Imagine that. That's the last episode of One Piece. Blackbeard finds it, does a wicked nose grind, but then trips and kills himself.
Yeah, face plants, so he fucking bails and dies. Oh my god.
That's the last episode of One Piece.
Ah, yeah, 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 yeah.
Superman plays in the background.
Yeah.
Luffy jumps out of a helicopter.
Here I am, growing older all the time. Pop shovels and dies. He simply cannot handle the power of the One Piece. The One Piece of gear to finish your dope ass board.
You shouldn't have picked school. Big factory.
Or
hangar.
It's hangar. I don't know why you didn't pick hangar.
You should have picked hangar, you dumb idiot.
You should have put in the Chico that makes you Spider-Man, fucking moron.
Obviously. God. He only knew the one that made you the Neversoft logo.
Oh, that disgusting eyeball.
I hate that guy. It's like, here kids play a game. It's an eyeball, then a rusty needle comes and stabs it.
That was his devil fruit.
Is that getting you in the mood for skateboarding, huh? Stabbing eye monsters?
Stabbing eye monster. This is surely the final boss. It's so hard. I'm also a little busy talking about. Oh, okay. I will die instantly. Thank you very much.
He wasn't even using the power.
Okay, and you just did it again. Very good. Now I'm going to button mash. That's what's going to happen.
It was just a throw. He went, eh. You know what I'm going to say.
What's that?
Punch him in the dick.
Punch him in the dick. Is that the name? Is that going to be the name of this episode?
I don't know.
Because you named the last episode "Make Him a Woman" or whatever.
I did, to turn him into a woman. Actually, the name of this episode might be Tony D. Hawk.
Bam D. Margera, please. Tony D. Hawk. Oh my god! All right, I need to actually get serious and beat this guy now.
All right.
All right, get serious.
All jokes aside.
Oh, please play. I don't know, something from Kill Switch Engage. Do you have any tracks from Green Day's Dookie?
Quick, Frank, put on Moon Gravity. Big head mode. That
big
might
head mode,
you.
Quick. Like you said, I should have chosen Hangar.
Behind that rock is the K, so you can spell skate.
The One Piece is that. You have to spell One Piece.
The One Piece is the last tape you need for that stage.
I'd love someone to
try to collect all of the tapes in the grand line. It's one more. I can't find it. I went up onto the glass where you grind in, and then all
fell
the glass
through.
Is breaking. I fall through. I can't get into that room up there. How do you do it? I grind on the rail and I jump, but I don't make it.
Oh, I hate that. I was around crying and I get hurt.
I love the externally, obviously. I hate what it's mean, but the hate-inspired victory where a game beats you and you're like, you know what, game? You can suck it. You're not going to beat me, you inanimate object. you bunch of ones and zeros. I'm a real man, and I'm gonna be you.
I have a job, alright?
I grew up.
I don't have responsibilities.
You try and treat me like a boy, I'm not.
I'm not a boy.
I'm not a boy anymore. I'm a real man.
I'm a real man.
I can be you. I bought you. I beat you.
I own you.
You're mine.
I can crack the sky or whatever. Why is it? He's not doing anything. Sky crack.
Release the crack.
Stop. Oh my god.
That's Blackbeard. That's what he sounds like.
Stop. I'm not a boy anymore. I'm a man.
I'm a big boy.
I'm a big boy now. I can win at games.
You won't beat me, Teach.
Oh yeah, I beat him.
K-Cross.
Ah, yeah, 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 yeah. Wow.
End of battle
death. End of battle death. Oh, he's dead.
Which there is treasure. Wink at audience.
Bing. Half of my beard is...
It will change the world forever.
Cindered off.
It will change the world. It's probably just the true history, right? Although that's what Robin's looking for.
What Robin's looking for.
It's probably going to be that there was a world and then the government blew it up and that's why there's islands now. There used to be countries and then the government, like, started a war and they blew the shit out of everything. And there's only islands left.
That's your call?
Sure. Or they flooded the world like in Wind Waker? Something like that.
So, here's my theory. One Piece is, one of the Dragon Balls that exist in Dragon Ball Super. The really big ones.
Oh, okay. It's the planet.
They're across dimensions. And when they get to the One Piece, Goku turns up and eviscerates them. And then he takes the thing.
I don't get it. That was symbolic.
Why was that? Because it's him?
Because they said he had, like...
Look at him! Aww!
Wow. They said he had, like, 400 gunshots and 3 million stab wounds and stuff, but none on his back because he never turned away from a fight. Look at him. He doesn't even have a beard.
And he still has a fucking grotesque chin.
He has that, but he has beautiful locks, though.
He does. Look at that Diamond Josu.
That's sad. He died with only half a mustache.
No man should go that way.
No man should go that way with but half a mustache. My son may be stupid.
I died.
There's no answer there. Episode Whitebeard. Finished!
Woohoo! We did it! Ay, 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 ay. Oh,
we get to play as a Kainu.
Ooh.
Shit.
We're going to have to save that one.
For another day.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
One Piece, Ollie, Flip, Pop, Shove It, Coffin.
So here I am, going older all the time, looking older all the time, feeling younger in my mind. I'm already losing.
Turn into a woman quickly.
Can I do that?
That's his power, right? Is he can swap genders?
Is that right?
Yeah.
And does he look different?
Yeah, and he can swap the genders of other people as well.
Oh, I didn't know
that's
that.
His ability.
I am already dying. Am I meant to be dying? I feel like I'm not meant to be dying, but he's absolutely decimating me.